So here I am, a beautiful weekend at the lake. What can I say? How blessed am I? Anyway, I want to do a short video on the process of getting from the amygdala, the old caveman software in the brain, to the prefrontal cortex where we do the critical thinking. And what I want to talk about is just how many of us, and a lot of this is through technology as well, the inability to process the excessiveness. So we're looping around in here and we can't process a lot of stuff because it is excessive. But understanding that, you know, with the amygdala, that we could potentially be stuck in that fear program. And a lot of the time, certain media, the news, the papers, is based on fear a lot of the time. And we know we've got a lot of fear and hysteria at the moment coming in via the media channels and misinformation and this information. So in regards to the old software, the fear, the amygdala, is the freeze, the shutting down. And with a lot of this information, it can just really, it just can be tiring and draining because you can't process it. It's excessive, it's outside of you. You don't have control over a lot of things. It's scary, it's worrying. And you know, with the freeze comes the potential freeze, flight and fight. And that flight, you know, we don't want to face things, and then we fight, we got a resistance towards things. And the reality is, in that process, is that just realizing the gateway from the amygdala to the prefrontal cortex is realizing that there is no woolly mammoth looking to attack us, but there is potentially a challenge ahead of us, be it adversity, be it the smallest problems and challenges. And learning to move from the amygdala, the old software, to the prefrontal cortex is really changing your perception and understanding that, you know, stress in today's world is just a process. Our thoughts, feelings and emotions are a process, and that's what we've got to learn to do. We've got to learn to process through things. So moving from the fear, the old software, the amygdala, to the prefrontal cortex, we've got to have that perception inside of us that we can breathe, we can think, we can be in the moment, and we can do the critical thinking. And a lot of us are not doing enough critical thinking and really getting our heads around a lot of things. So the ability to respond with a freeze, flight and fight, being able to move into the prefrontal cortex, to move from reaction, potentially reaction, to response, is then that we can move deeper. When we're more in our bodies and we're in our hearts, and you know, as we grow through life, a lot of us can go through relationships that can be potentially challenging. We don't process. We have, maybe like myself, the wounded child, abandonment. So a lot of the times the heart doesn't really get to, as an adult, get to work with a certain, you know, depth of awareness, because we've so much deeper processing to do. When we hit our teens, we hit the kind of the stages of life where we've got to find out which direction we want to go in. So when we do have that awareness, that stress, that pressure, the challenges, everything is a process. Everything is a process. Your thoughts, your feelings, your emotions, energy in motion, the process, that life's a journey. And that when we learn to respond from the heart, that's a bright responder. We're bright, we're alive, we're charged, we're managing things. And that's the key. And the difference is, in the body, in our system, is that when we're in the amygdala, quite often we get that adrenaline dump, we get that feeling and that charge that we struggle with. We feel it in certain parts of our body depending on the emotion. And what happens then is, you know, the link from the head to the endocrine system is the hypothalamus, and that's where that chain effect comes to the endocrine system. And then we're in the nervous system, and the sympathetic nervous system is where a lot of the stress and stuff that we don't process can kind of hang out in the nervous system, that we get charged very quick through circumstances. And that what we need to learn to do is, the parasympathetic nervous system is, once we start to get control, understand the process from the journey from the amygdala to the prefrontal cortex, to really be more in the heart, aware, grounded, to process through things, is that when we start to do that, and especially with exercise and movement, is we start to really spend more time in the parasympathetic nervous system, which is where, that's your restorative system. That's where we really feel the benefit of yoga and boxing and martial arts, because we feel calmer, we feel grounded when we're in the parasympathetic nervous system. So I just wanted to take you on a little journey from the amygdala to the prefrontal cortex, then to the heart, being more in our body, especially through exercising, and being able to process through our deepest thoughts and feelings, and understanding that, you know, even when we do struggle to move from reaction to response, is that then moving your body allows your body to disperse the stress buildup that we could potentially have, which causes or can potentially cause a lot of reactions, negative reactions in life, that, you know, certain patterns of behaviors that many of us can experience. So I wanted to share that with you today. And yeah, just think about, you know, the key to really being able to move from the amygdala to the prefrontal cortex is just getting a realization of changing your perception and understanding that life's a journey, it's a process. You're not your thoughts, you're not your feelings. The energy is the emotions are energy in motion, and that you've got to go through the process and not be a stress collector. Deal with the way you feel in life. So I wanted to share that today, the journey from the amygdala to the prefrontal cortex to the heart, and just give you some insight into really, you know, developing that self-awareness in our, you know, internal world, in our human biology. Have a great day.